Hi there. I think we're going to do a screencast on Booleans. Boolean operations in 3D are really popular, especially among new 3D program users, just because it's a really quick and easy way to get geometry out of primitive shapes. What I mean by that is here we have a cuboid and a sphere. These are just using the default resolution and geometry that you get in Cinema 4D. Now, if you're new to 3D, you start to stack objects and you're like, oh, this is cool. I can put a couple of spheres on top of the cube and sort of start to build a shape. Maybe I can put a cylinder coming out of there and you can really quickly realize your vision. Now, when it comes to creating negative geometry, you see people use Boolean operations quite a lot. And the way a Boolean operation works is, at least by default in Cinema 4D, you take object A and you subtract the volume of object B from it. So in this case, we are subtracting the sphere from the cube. You can even go right through and sort of punch a hole through the object. And in general, it's a really quick and easy way to make new geometry. But it does come at a cost. The cost is that all of these intersections and geometric cuts are being made by computer algorithms. Cinema 4D thinks that this is the best way to triangulate the surface, so it does it. And to be honest, it's usually right about what the best way is. But things can get complicated. What if you wanted to smooth the edges of this cube when you're done? Well, what you'll do is you'll say, I want a single object, hide new edges, or maybe not hide new edges. And then you would convert the current state to an object. You can delete the original, and what you're left with is this shape. And you can then say, okay, I want to take these four edges here, and I want to use a bevel on them. And I can say, okay, it's like a convex bevel with three segments. And when you start to bevel it, nasty stuff happens. You get edges splitting up. You get way more triangles than you started with. The geometry at the edge here looks like a mess. It's just really undesirable. So again, you're a bit of an amateur in 3D and you say, well, maybe I could just smooth all that stuff out. That seems like the easy way. So you take a hypernurbs object and you put your geometry in there. Not only does it not fix your problem, it actually makes it worse. If I switch out of quick shading lines just back to quick shading, you can see here that now it's just wreaking havoc on your geometry. This geometry is just ruined. And at the end of the day, a new 3D user may look at this and get frustrated. So, how do we fix this? How do we use Booleans in a responsible way? Well, I've boiled it down to three simple tips. Number one, try to use simple geometry. Number two, try to prep the areas where your geometry is going to intersect. And number three, clean up after yourself. So let's look at number one, simple geometry. Let's create that exact same situation that we just had, except using simpler geometry. It's important to understand here that simple geometry doesn't always mean less geometry. It just means make it simpler. Simpler for the computer to understand and simpler for you to fix when things go wrong. So I'm going to create my Boolean object and I'm going to put my cube and sphere in it. Again, by default, sphere subtracts from cube and I wanted my sphere at the edge over here. So, let's start by making this geometry simpler. I'm going to go back to my quick shading lines and triangles everywhere, a lot of complicated geometry, not necessarily what I would call simple. But if we add more segments to the cube, this is counterintuitive because it feels like we're making it more complex. But let's do it nonetheless. If we add more segments to the cube on the X and the Z, we can actually simplify the operation that Cinema 4D needs to do. So what we've seen here is that the rest of the object stays very simple, and the area where the intersection is going to happen becomes a little complicated. But that's okay, because as long as we prep our area that's going to be operated on by the Boolean, and then clean up after ourselves, we'll be fine. So already this is great. We have a cube that is in general subdivided, but very untouched by the Boolean, and that's a good thing. So we've got our concave area here. The next thing I think we might be able to do is change our sphere. So if we reduce the number of segments in the sphere, we can again simplify the area that is going to be Boolean. Like that. Now, what did I mean by prepping geometry? What I meant by that is that if your sphere, now notice this horizontal ring of segments here on the far side. If your sphere is just intersecting like that and you end up with this double line of geometry, that's a good example of where you might want to prep your geometry better. That's going to be harder to clean up, and in areas like this, it's going to create more complicated geometry. So, to clean this area up, what I suggest we do is simply move the sphere so it doesn't create that extra ring of edges. You can also do things like rotate the sphere. So I'm just going to rotate it a little bit, and you see as I rotate it, the triangulation changes. Well, what if I could rotate it so that the triangulation becomes friendlier? Like that. I think that's a good start. So what we've done is we've isolated where the Boolean will happen, and we've simplified the operation. I'm going to simplify it even further by reducing the number of segments in the sphere again. Reason being that I plan on using a hypernurbs on this later to smooth everything out. Now, the next thing we need to do is clean up after ourselves. There's a lot of extra edges here that we didn't ask for. We can't get rid of them, they're just part of the Boolean process, but what we can do is clean up after ourselves. So I'm going to go to the Boolean object, make sure high quality is still on, just to give you an idea of what low quality looks like. Cinema 4D generally just doesn't try as hard. And then we can say create a single object, because it's easier to clean up. And we can say hide new edges, if we wanted to. I'm going to leave the edges shown for clarity. And then we can simply select this object and press C. That gives us a single polygon object, where all of these faces are now connected and the Boolean has sort of happened already. Now we clean up. I like to go to point mode and use the live selection tool. What I normally do is say to myself, okay, this part of the geometry is a part we asked for, this ring at the edge of the sphere. We didn't really ask for this part. I understand why it happened. It happened because edges from the cube intersected the sphere right there. Fact is, we don't want it. So, using our live selection tool, we can select all these points, and then using the weld tool, we can weld all of these points to that point. And this is something that I'm just going to repeat. I'm going to hold down Q to get my live selection tool. Mine is bound to the keyboard shortcut Q. Yours might be different. I don't remember if that's default. And we simply just select some edges, clean them up. Select some edges. Now, we gotta look carefully. Which one of these is the original edge? I think it's this one here. And we just go around the object doing that. I'm gonna sort of speed up here so that we can just get that done. Select the edges. Go to our weld tool. Weld them. Now, we know we're done when the intersecting edges, I'm going to go to my edge mode here and choose loop selection. When the intersecting edges, loop selection is not being kind to me. Maybe I can do a greedy search. Nope, that doesn't make it better. Let's get rid of some of these edges on the inside and see if that helps. Maybe if I got rid of this diagonal edge and this one here, you can get rid of those by just using the melt command. Maybe I can select my loop a little bit easier now. There we go. So if I select this loop of edges, I can see that it's the same number of edges we started with on the sphere, and it's all lined up. So this is a good step at cleaning up, but we're not done. The next thing I like to do in cleaning up is get rid of all these triangles and then rebuild the shape. We know that quads are good, and I sort of demonstrated what happens when you have too many triangles earlier. If you have too many triangles and you try to do that hypernurbs, it's just going to explode. So I'm going to select all these edges and I'm going to melt them. That gets rid of them. Already, you see, Cinema 4D has tried to simplify our geometry. So this is a good step. We can then sort of use our knife tool. We can just right-click and get the knife. Restrict to selection? No. Line mode? Yes. Visible only? Yes. So, and then we can just sort of start to cut our geometry up. So we want to cut it up to maintain quads. So every time we cut, we try to keep it as quads. Quad, quad. It's a tricky one here, but if we do like that, we can get a quad. I'm going to leave this as a triangle, because at this point it would be stretching it to try to make that a quadrangle. and make that a quad. Make this a quad as well. It looks like Cinema 4D is already making all of these quads for us. That's good. Okay, and we have another triangle over here. But except for those two triangles that we encountered, these are all quads now. And we can also go to our Phong tag and reduce that to like 40 degrees, something to give us back our sharp edge. Now here's another little trick. If you have a pair of triangles, it's actually quite easy to make them into quads. What you do is you draw a path from one triangle to the other. One triangle right here, we have another triangle right there. If we wanted to make both of these quadrangles, the only real way to do that is to introduce more geometry. So this may not be ideal for all situations, but it's going to work for this one. We select all of the faces in between them, sort of draw a path. So these are the quads between these two triangles. Then we can choose our knife tool, change it to path mode. That's going to draw a path along our selection. And then we just go roughly halfway along it and then cut. We've created some more geometry, but we've also fixed the quad situation. Now, these are, I believe, degenerate polygons at the moment, where you have collinear points, three points all lined up together. That's usually not a good thing. So we can use our slide tool and slide the point out. And we do the same thing here, slide the point out. Now we have all quads. This object, save for the top of the sphere, we can even fix that. I'll show you how to fix those quads. When the sphere, providing it has an even number of edges, does it? We select all these, it has 12 edges, so that means we can fix it. You just select every other edge in this sort of star configuration, and then you melt them. So now this object is all quads. If we wanted to further clean up this messy sort of line we made here, we can select those points, deselect this one that I selected erroneously, and then we can use the brush tool. Brush, there it is. And we can change the mode to smooth. By default it's smear, but we want smooth. Change the strength to something pretty low, 2% is usually where I start, and then you just sort of apply the brush, and you see it's sort of shifting those points very gradually. And what it's going to do is it's going to try to find the median between the points. So it's just going to move them around until they're more settled. On our previous example, when we added this object to a hypernurbs to try to smooth it, things went wrong. In this case, we can add the object to the hypernurbs and it still looks pretty good. We can even come in here, go to where our Boolean happened, and because our geometry is nice and clean, we can do things like use the knife tool in loop mode and then add an extra ring of geometry right there to harden it up. In our previous example, we tried to do a bevel around the edges and it didn't work very well. In this example, we can do a loop selection around the edges. We can do our bevel with the same convex, three segments, and it's actually manageable. It's not perfect in this area, but it's so much easier to fix than it was before. So these skills are really learned. You know, you develop these tips over time, you figure this stuff out as you try and try again. It's so easy to say, oh, Booleans are bad, we should never use Booleans. But in this case I used Booleans, but I just remembered to clean up after myself. You need to prep the geometry and make sure that you understand what's going to happen when you do this Boolean operation, and then you make sure that you're prepared to clean up after it, because oftentimes Booleans just require a little bit of extra effort to clean up what's left behind. And after a little bit of cleanup after this bevel, I'm not sure what happened there. Ah, we've got a hidden polygon. So if I just do a selection there, we can see we have a polygon sort of hiding in there. We can delete that. And what we have here is a pretty respectable piece of geometry that has that Boolean. If I turn off the lines, you can see it's very, very clean. It's good stuff. So that's one example of how cleaning up a Boolean with those three steps sort of, simplify the geometry, prep the area, and then clean up after yourself can sort of help you with your Booleans. I'm actually going to do another video, just like this one, but showing you a different approach, a different type of geometry. We're going to join two pipes. So I hope you come back and join me for that video. Thanks for watching.